Today my topic is quality control and quality assurance. So today topic will be discussed quality control and quality assurance has to be done to control quality, levels of quality control, tools required, and problem based areas. What is quality control? Quality control is a series of tests to assure radiographic system is functioning properly and radiographs are of acceptable quality. So quality control tests should be conducted for X-ray machine and also CT, ultrasound, MRI, and mammography. So logs of tests performed, dates, result, and corrective action should be kept. What is quality assurance? An organized effort by staff operating a facility to ensure that the diagnostic image produced are of sufficiently high quality, so that they consistently provide adequate diagnostic information at the lowest possible cost and with the least possible exposure of the patient of radiation. So in quality assurance program, this program has many facts including quality control test, administered procedure, preventive maintenance procedure, and training. So what are the tests we are doing? Few of them are central beam alignment, focal spot size, tube voltage, timer check, and tube housing leakage. So first is central beam alignment. So if the X-ray beam is not perpendicular to the image receptor, the image may be distorted. If grid is used, to the distortion will be magnified, resulting in total loss of minute detail. So focal spot size, the ability for resolving the smallest size of the image, that is details in a radiograph, depends on the focal spot size. So since the focal spot size may be altered as a result of bombardment of electron on the target, it has to be checked periodically to ensure that the focal spot size is within acceptable limits. So we'll share what could be the tool to check those. So next is tube voltage. So the applied KVP, the quality and quantity of the X-ray reaching the image receptor. So if there is variation in KVP setting, it will affect the image quality. Hence, it is necessary to check the KVP setting periodically. So next is timer checking. So if the exposure time set on the diagnostic X-ray unit is not optimal, the radiograph can be underexposed or overexposed. So this may lead to repeat examinations. Hence, there is need to test the timer of the X-ray unit periodically. Next is tube housing leakage. So tube housing leakage of radiation from the X-ray tube housing adds the radiation dose to the patient and to the operator too. So tube housing leakage test must be periodically done to ensure the radiation safety. So what is the tool required for beam alignment test? So beam alignment test tool is kept on the collimated test tool such way that the stainless steel ball of lower side of tool is just above the center of the collimated test tool. So the film is exposed and processed. So if the beam alignment is perfect, the image of the top ball will merge with the image of the ball at the bottom. So the deviation of beam from the perpendicular is determined from the location of the image of top ball in the circle in the radiographs. So this is the tool we are using for the beam alignment test, and these are the balls. So if it is within the limits, so this is the tool which is used as a beam alignment test tool. So if the ball exposed is within the limits, limit would be 0.4 inches. So it is within the limit, so test is okay. If it is not within the limits, so it can be, the image can be distorted, or we have to do some service settings. So next is focal spot test tool. So that test tool consists of hollow cylinder with an acrylic circular disc fastened at one end, which contains 12 group of bar patterns engraved on a tungsten plate. So each group test of 6 lines, subgroup of 3 parallel lines perpendicular to another subgroup whose size and spacing decrease by a step of 16%. So the focal spot size value are computed for magnification of 4/3 beam FFD 60 centimeter and object to focal distance 45. So this is the table which is showing which group, how many line pair per mm at which focal spot size. So test tool placed on a non-screen cassette loaded with film. Constraints such that vertical pattern are within the anode to cathode direction. So film is exposed and processed, and bar pattern on radiograph is observed. Smallest group on which all six bar are clearly resolved is identified, and corresponding focal spot size can be obtained from the table. So this is the tool we are using for the focal spot size. So in this image, we could be able to understand, in this we could be able to see all the lines, which is clear. So image resolution would be better in this area with the 1.8 to 2.0. Or also in this, it is clearly visible in 1.8 to 2.2. It is clearly visible. So we can say the image resolution would be better in this area. So next is timer checking. So for timer checking, we will do spinning top test tool. So a spinning top test tool is used to check the exposure time. So it consists of a rotating circular brass plate with a small rectangular portion as its periphery. The tool is placed on the cassette loaded with film. For a set time, the unit is energized while the top is rotating. So the pulses passing through the hole of the circular plate produces equally spaced rectangular density patterns on the film. So this is the tool which we are using for the timer checking. In the three phase, it will show you in arc shape, and in single phase, it will show you in dots or dashes shape. So the next is tube voltage. So KVP meter is the tool which we are using for tube voltage. KVP meter employs two solid state detectors with different beam hardening filters. So when exposed to radiation, the ratio of the signal produced by these detectors will be proportional to the peak tube voltage. So correction for beam filtration should be applied if necessary. So this is the KVP meter. So next is tube housing leakage. Radiation survey meter will be used for this. So the radiation leakage measurement is carried with an ionizing radiation survey meter. For checking the leakage radiation, the collimator of tube housing is fully closed and the tube is energized at maximum rated tube potential and current at that KVP. So the exposure rate at 1 meter from the target is measured at different location from the tube housing and collimator. The tolerance limit of leakage radiation at 1 meter from the focus is 150 millirentgen in 1 hour. So this is the radiation survey meter. So the next is frequency of quality control. So what would be the frequency of the these tests? So for KVP testing, it should be done in once in 3 year. Timer checking, it should be done once in 3 months. Output, it should be done monthly. Inherent filtration, it should done once in 3 months. Focal spot size, it should done once in a year. Central beam alignment, it should done once in 2 months. Congruence of radiation and optical fields, it should done once in 2 months. And grid alignment, annually and whenever film density appears non-uniform. So whenever we will have non-uniform X-rays, we can do grid alignment test. So there is a committee for quality assurance. So in this, we will have discussion on committee and their roles. So medical physicist will be there, radiologist, biomedical engineer, imaging technologist, and IT technician. So the role of medical physicist is conducting tests to ensure the safety and proper performance of imaging equipment used. imaging of biomedical engineering services staff for corrective maintenance or preventive action, training of personnel utilized for quality control. So the role of a radiologist: determine the overall quality of the output image, select the technologist to be the primary QC technologist performing the prescribed QC test, ensure that appropriate test equipment and material are available to perform the QC test, ensuring that medical physicists and radiographers have adequate continuous education. So the role of biomedical engineer is corrective and preventive maintenance and fault reporting. Role of imaging technologist: ensuring that the appropriate protocol and technique factors are used for the requested examination, ensuring that the QC tests are performed, interpreted, and recorded appropriately, perform all the checks for the daily, monthly, and quarterly QC testing of equipment, report fault immediately, and deviation in trend of equipment performance to QA manager, undertaking additional continuous education courses. And in last, role of IT technician: maintenance of the integrity of system database to ensure continuous and accurate operation of the information systems. So thank you all for your attention and participation.